in Chicago, Illinois, where the beers still suck. It's a strategy, knowledge, and fun. Unless you're Jay Cutler, it's Tic-Tac-Dough.
And I'm Rodney 1279.
And I'm here to host it's a thought. Aaron Rodgers slipping in.
Welcome to season 5, episode 63 of Tic-Tac-Dough. Glad to have you with us. We're going to have an awesome time. I can feel it. Well, we have a second rematch between these two players. First, we're going to start with Eric Lima, who has only taken two turns in between these games. How you doing, Eric?
I am doing wonderful. Rodney, be back here on this great show.
Welcome back. And our returning champion who has won 4 wins and $243,919, it is Boris Alexander. How you doing, Boris?
Great. I think I will win today.
All right. Good luck to the both of you. Come out fighting. Here are the categories we'll be dealing with in today's game, and they are the following. Oh, no rematch today. So this is going to be a fair game today. There's going to be no more rematches. We have weather. Secret category. Choose the secret category, and you're correct in that category. The value of the pot will double. European history, the Gospels, current events. Now, if you choose the current events category, we'll add $2,500 to the overall jackpot for the Beat the Dragon game. If it's in the outer box. If it's in the center box like it is now, we'll add $5,000 to that jackpot, okay? Jump-in category. Cartoons. The $10,000 question and mixed game shows. I will unlock y'all controls. It's Eric and Quiz Gamer. And, Boris, whenever you're ready, go ahead and start picking.
I would like to start from the... $10,000 question.
Going right for the $10,000 question. To put $10,000 in the pot, here's your question. Which musical is set at Rydell High?
Could you repeat?
Which musical is set at Rydell High?
Riding High.
Say your answer one more time.
Riding High.
Riding High is wrong. Mm. The answer is Grease. Grease.
I would not.
Yeah, Grease. Okay, we shuffle. Your opportunity, Eric, to take first blood.
You draw first blood.
Yeah.
Okay, I got two categories that are my favorite up there. Let's try mixed game shows in the upper left.
All right, going with mixed game shows. We're going to still do Chuck Barris game shows here. Take a look at this mixed up game show. All right, take a look at this mixed game show. This mixed game show that was hosted by Bob Barker plays very much like the Newlywed Game. Kids try to match the answers their parents say and that the parents do the same thing. Name this mixed game show.
It'll be the Family Game.
Right you are. Good job. We're going to put $2,000 in the pot and the circle goes on the board. $2,000 is in there and we shuffle. All right, Boris.
Let's go with mixed game shows.
He's going with mixed game shows. Second time in the category. Take a look at this one. It's another Chuck Barris game show.
Folks.
That's okay.
Deadly guy.
All right, here is your question, Boris. This comedy game show that was hosted by Wink Martindale contains a jury of 5 unmarried men and 5 unmarried women to help pick the mother-in-law they are most likely to have. There are 3 celebrities to present their case. Name the show.
How's your mother-in-law?
You got it. Good job. That's going to put another $2,000 in the pot. We have $4,000 in there and we shuffle. All right, Eric.
Let's see. Let's try the secret category in the upper right.
All right. The secret category. You answer the question in the secret category, we'll double the pot to $8,000, okay?
Got it.
What movie award appears in the International Radio Alphabet? Again, what movie award appears in the International Radio Alphabet?
Oscars?
We doubled the pot to $8,000. Nicely done. Good job. We have $8,000 in the pot and we shuffle. All right, Boris.
Secret.
All right, to double the pot again, this will double the pot to $16,000, and you have a successful block, okay?
It works.
What kind of natural disaster destroyed 3 of the 7 wonders of the ancient world to double the pot?
Earthquake.
Repeat again.
Earthquake.
We double it again to $16,000.
It's in the bank here, Rodney.
Yeah. All right. $16,000 is in the pot. We shuffle. Eric.
Oh, it's a tough call to make here. Let's try the jumping category.
All right. Jumping category. All right. Here's you go. So, Boris has the X button, the X on his keypad, and Eric has the circle or the O on his keypad. I'm gonna read you the question. Whoever gets this question right, we'll have that box. We'll add $2,000 in the pot. Miss the question, the other gets the box automatically, and we'll put $2,000 in the pot. Okay.
Okay. Nothing.
Yep. What kind of animal is Chuck? Let me try again. What kind of animal is Chuck E. Cheese?
I'm trying to buzz.
Oh, you are trying to buzz? Okay. All right, wait a minute. He buzzed in first. He called for it first. So it is Eric. Eric, what's your answer?
A mouse.
It is a mouse. Good job.
I buzzed.
But see, he said he was trying to buzz in. You didn't say anything. You buzzed in after he said it. Is that right, Judge?
I didn't hear him say he tried to buzz in.
Right. So it's Eric. Now, even though it says $16,000, what we're gonna do? We're gonna put the box up there as a circle. It's $18,000 in the pot. So just to remember that, okay?
All right.
It's $18,000 in the pot. You got it right, Eric. Okay.
Yes.
All right, and we shuffle. All right, Boris.
Let's go with the European history.
European history for one of the blocks. It's going to be a two-part question, and you'll get the extra time on it, okay?
Okay.
Where was English poet John Keats born on October 31st, 1795? Is it A, Edinburgh, Scotland, B, Dublin, Ireland, C, Cardiff, Wales, or D, London, England? That's the first one. The second one, what did Communist Poland's government ban on October 8th, 1982? And this should be an easy one because you're in Poland. Is it A, the Protestant church? B, consumption of alcohol? C, practice of the Jewish religion? Or D, all labor organization? Here's the time to think about it. Which one you want to try first, Boris?
Let's go for the first one.
The first one. Where was English poet John Keats born on October 31st, 1795? Is it A, Edinburgh, Scotland? B, Dublin, Ireland? C, Cardiff, Wales? Or D, London, England?
He was born in London.
Good job. Now for the center box. What did communist Poland's government ban? Here we go again with this stuff. Hold on. Stand by, y'all.
Luke file.
I hate this. Sorry about that, folks.
Darth Vader.
Yeah, I gotta get this off the screen.
Hit the stop button.
Yeah. Hang on. Sorry about this. Why this has to pop up all the doggone time? There we go. Sorry about that, folks. You got the first one. Here's the second question. What did communist Poland's government ban on October 8th, 1982? Is it A, the Protestant church? B, consumption of alcohol? C, practice of the Jewish religion? Or D, all labor organization?
The first one.
The Protestant church?
Yep.
Incorrect. It was all labor organization. All labor organization.
Oh, shocking you get that one.
Yeah. We shuffle. Yep. All right, Eric.
I'm going to have to go with current events for the win.
And we're going to put $2,500 in the jackpot. Now, you get this question right on the current events, it'll be Tic-Tac-Dough. $20,000 because we owe you $2,000 for that box. And you'll be the new champion, okay? Here's your current events question. This is based off of this month, okay? Released in January of 2017, That's the Way I Like topped the charts around the world in May 2017 for which artist? Is it A, Justin Timberlake? B, Bruno Mars? C, Mark Ronson? Or D, Ed Sheeran?
Wait, I like Ed Sheeran?
Ed Sheeran is wrong.
Bruno Mars!
Yep, Bruno Mars. Bruno
That's
Mars.
What I like. That's what I like.
Yep, Bruno Mars. All right, we shuffle. Boris is still in the game. All right, Boris.
Let's try again, history.
Okay, going with European history again. Two-parter again. You'll get the extra time on this one. All right. We'll use these two. Here we go. All right. First, King Henry VIII had his chief minister executed on July 18th, 1540. Who was this chief minister? Is it A, Thomas Wolsey? B, Oliver Cromwell? C, Thomas Cromwell? Or D, Thomas Cranmer? And the second one, which country was the first to use tanks in an attack at the Fleur Corselet during World War I? Is it A, Britain? B, Germany? C, France? Or D, Russia? Here's the time to think about it. All right, Boris, which part you want to answer first?
Again, with the first one, please.
King Henry VIII had his chief minister executed on July 28, 1540. Who was this chief minister? Is it A, Thomas Wolsey? B, Oliver Cromwell? C, Thomas Cromwell? Or D, Thomas Cranmer?
Thomas Cromwell. The third one.
Thomas Cromwell is right. And the second one, which country was the first to use tanks in an attack at Fleur-Corcelet during World War I? Is it A, Britain, B, Germany, C, France, or D, Russia?
Germany.
Germany is wrong.
Oh,
it's Britain. Britain. Okay, we shuffle. All right, Eric.
Cartoons for the diagonal win.
All right, again, two-part question. You get this question right on cartoons, it'll be Tic-Tac-Dough, $21,000, and you'll be the new champion. Here's your question on cartoons. What is the name of the van on the show Scooby-Doo? Is it A, Ecto, B, Mystery Machine, C, Scooby Van, or D, the Case Closer? And the second one, which is not the name of one of the Animaniacs? Is it A, Zany, B, Wacko, C, Dot, or D, Yakko? Here's the time to think about it. All right, Eric, which part you want to answer first?
One, Rodney.
Which one again?
The van and the Scooby-Doo one.
Okay, what is the name of the van on the show Scooby-Doo? Is it A, Ecto, B, Mystery Machine, C, Scooby Van, or D, the Case Closer?
That will be the Mystery Machine.
Yes. And for Tic-Tac-Dough and $21,000, which is not the name of one of the Animaniacs? Is it A, Zany, B, Wacko, C, Dot, or D, Yakko?
Zany.
Yeah, Tic-Tac-Dough! All right. So you have a total of $21,000, actually.
Wow.
And you're the new champion, Eric, okay? And you're going to go ahead against that dragon shortly. Boris, you have four wins right now. $243,919. You're in fifth place. I think that's pretty much safe, okay? And we'll definitely have you for another game, okay?
Okay.
All right. Well, Eric, well, we're going to first take a commercial break, guys. And when we come back, we'll do more Tic-Tac-Dough. Stick with us, won't you?
I will. Oh, boy. If I'm the air sled guy.
All right, guys. Welcome to Tic-Tac-Dough. We're ready to do the Beat the Dragon game. And Eric is our new champion with $21,000. And you ready to go ahead and see this dragon and stuff?
I'm going to make it like a knight and slay that dragon.
There you go. Remember, in order to win the game, you have to get $10,000 or get the ticking attack before seeing him. If you do all of that, here's the prizes you could win. Neo? All
right. Today, Tic-Tac-Dough, you could win the following. A trip to Honolulu. A garage motor car. A trip to Portugal. A trip to Boston. Then, your Peter William on TV. A trip to Montreal. And that's why we're $35,706. Good luck.
Thank you, and bless you, Justin. And, if you get the tick and attack on any of your picks, the jackpot was at $42,500, but because, I forgot who picked it. You picked the current events, Eric?
The one with the
That's
What I Like?
Yeah, who picked the current events?
I did.
Yeah,
I did.
So we added another $2,500 to that jackpot. Is that $45,000 if you get the tick and attack? Do it on your first two picks. We'll double that bonus to $90,000 and a shot at a new car. Let's cover up that board. If you're ready to go, let's do this.
I see a number seven.
Let's see what's in number seven. There's $2,500. Good start.
Risk that $2,500 on call. No, on box number nine.
Let's see what's in number nine. There's the tack. Find the ticket. We give you a $45,000 bonus, Eric, and a shiny new car.
I sense the tick is at number three.
You sense it at number three. Do you feel it, Eric? Do you feel it?
I feel it. Number three.
He feels it. Let me go ahead and hit the button right. Oh, there's something in my eye. There's something in my eye. No, $6,500. I'm just kidding, of course. Stop or go.
It was in your eye there. You gotta pluck it out. Okay, I'm gonna keep going. Risk that $6,500. And I'm going for number one. Numero uno, baby.
He's gonna go number one. Is Tick or the $3,500 behind number one? You're in it! That's the total of $55,000 in cash and the prize package. Let's see where that dragon was.
Which one's, number four.
Number four. So $90,786, Eric. Good going.
Thank you very much. I like it.
You ready to see what car you're going for?
Let's show it. What's the car?
It's a new 2016 Audi A7 Pristine. Was $73,291.
All right,
where is the car at, Eric? Is it in Tick or Tack?
Tack, Rodney. Tack.
Which model do you want me to do from the Price is Right?
Model?
Yeah, which model off the Price is Right do you like? The women on the Price is Right, Eric?
Amber.
Amber? Okay, I'll do Amber. Oh, I wish some man could have you, but unfortunately, you're taken already. That's it. No. Well, that's too bad. But you still have your winnings of $90,876, Eric. We give you a previous winnings of $21,000. That gives you a total of $111,786.
Yes, sir. That's what the phone shows would say. Yes, sir.
Is that right? Wait a minute, is that total right? Did I say 21,000? Yeah, that's not right.
Yeah, that's right, Ron. You got it right.
20,000, I believe.
21,000.
You know what I did wrong? I written it wrong on my paper. Yeah, that's what I did. I written it wrong on my paper. So it's 111,786. There we go. I'm getting dyslexic. Okay, well, Eric, go to the X spot. And Neil, who is our challenger?
Our challenger today is Ian. Welcome to the studio.
Hey, Ian.
Hey, Ron.
Well, Ian, not too many episodes left. If you want to get into that tournament, you got to win it now.
Let's hope so.
All right. Good luck to both of you. Here are the nine categories that we'll be dealing with, and they are the following. We have inventors and inventions. Secret category, kids trivia, current events, Old Testament, double or nothing, NHL teams, opponent's choice, and millionaire. All right, Eric, if you please.
Let's try kid trivia in the upper right.
Before I light that up, I'm going to go ahead and block y'all buzzers because y'all don't need it. No jumpings here.
God.
And kids trivia, here's your question on kids trivia. In which game would you buy properties? Is it A, Scrabble, B, Clue, C, Monopoly, or D, Life?
Monopoly.
Obviously, that is right. $2,000 in the pot and we shuffle it. All right, Ian.
Current events, please.
He's going to current events. This is his favorite category. And we're going to add another $2,500 to that overall jackpot, too. And here's your question. Prince Philip, Duke of Edinburgh, gave up public service in May of 2017. How old was he at the time? Is it A, 85, B, 90, C, 100, or D, 95?
That'll be 95.
Right you are. Good job. $4,000 is in the pot and we shuffle. All right, Eric.
Let's try kids trivia again.
Second time in the category. Your question. What color is Auburn? A-U-B-U-R-N, Auburn. Is it A, blue, B, yellow, C, green, or D, red?
Red.
Red is right. Good job. $6,000 is in the pot and we shuffle. All right, Ian.
Old Testament, please.
Old Testament for the block. Your question. Which priest was in charge of rebuilding the temple after the Babylonian exile? I repeat it again. Which priest was in charge of rebuilding the temple after the Babylonian exile? Is it A, Nehemiah, B, Zadok, C, Ezra, or D, Abiathar?
Can you repeat again, please?
Which priest was in charge of rebuilding the temple after the Babylonian exile? Is it A, Nehemiah, B, Zadok, C, Ezra, or D, Abiathar? Yeah, about 10 seconds.
C, I don't know.
You going with Ezra?
Yep.
That's a good guess. That's right. Good job.
Whoa, that was close.
You can find that scripture in Ezra, the 7th chapter, verse 12. Very nicely done. Good guess. We shuffle.
Don't read the Bible, bud. Yep.
All right, Eric.
I'm going to have to go with Millionaire in the Center for the Block.
Going with Millionaire for the Block. It's going to be a two-part question worth $3,000, and I will give you extra time on that, okay?
Got it.
First, which of these is not an American plane from World War II? Is it A, the B-24, B, the Mustang, C, the Stuka, or D, the B-29 Super Fortress? That's the first one. And the second one, how many children did the woman listed under the most children category in the Guinness World of Records have? Is it A, 69, B, 25, C, 73, or D, 58? Here's your time to think about it. Now, I'll give you a hint. We had this question before. Which one you want to start with?
I'll try the first one. Can you read that one again?
Which of these is not an American plane from World War II? Is it A, B-24, B, Mustang, C, Stuka, or D, B-29 Super Fortress?
D, Stuka.
Very good. And for the center box, excuse me. How many children did the woman listed under the most children category in the Guinness Book of World Records have? Is it A, 69, B-25, C-73, or D-58?
25?
No. You remember we had this question on Mother's Day?
Is it 69?
It's 69, yes. Boris answered that question correctly. Yep. Yeah, we shuffle.
Everyone's favorite number.
All right. Oh, boy. Ian?
I'm dead.
Say it again.
Current events.
This is his favorite category. This might be trouble for you. You get this question right on current events, Ian, it'll be Tic-Tac-Dough. $11,000. You have your first win of the season. And we're going to have...
I hope.
Yes. We have $5,000 to that overall jackpot once this is over with. Okay, here's your current events question. First, who was fired from his position as the director of the FBI in May of 2017? Is it A, James Comey, B, John Podesta, C, Loretta Lynch, or D, Trey Gowdy? That's the first one. And the second one, Donald Trump ordered a further 5,000 troops to where in May of 2017? Is it A, Syria, B, Poland, C, Iraq, or D, Afghanistan? Here's your time to think about it. Ian, which part do I answer first?
The FBI one, please.
Who was fired from his position as the director of the FBI in May of 2017? Is it
James Comey.
You got that one. And for Tic-Tac-Dough and $11,000, Donald Trump ordered a further 5,000 troops to where in May of 2017? Is it A, Syria? He knows it, and it's Tic-Tac-Dough, we have a new champion!
Finally!
Nicely done, that's your first win. You need two more wins to go in order to get on that top eight. So you have $11,000 in, congratulations, and you're gonna go ahead against that dragon very shortly. Well, Eric, listen, you have your name already on the leaderboard anyway, and we hope your score holds up for the final two games, okay?
You got it. I beat the dragon. That's all that matters. Let's have some fun.
Yep. We'll take another commercial break, guys, and when we come back, we're going to finish this episode out with the Beat the Dragon game. Don't go away.
Yes! Yes, sir!
Welcome back to Tic-Tac-Dough. It's time for the Dragon Game. And here's your host of the blog, Aaron Rodgers Flippin.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Well, Ian, you finally won your first game of the season, Ian. You have $11,000. You'll be playing on tomorrow. And you know how the Beat the Dragon Game is played, so we're going to get right into it. Let's see what prizes you're in for, announcer guy.
Today you can win the following. The TV. A dining room group receives a trip to Antigua Bay, dining room group and dinnerware, and that's all worth $33,290. I'm sorry if I missed anything.
That's good. Thank you, Neil. Thank you. All right. Now, the jackpot was supposed to be originally at $25,000, but because Ian took a chance at the current events category two times, one in the center box and one in the outer box, we had $7,500 to the jackpot. That's $32,500 if you get the ticket attack. During your first two picks, we give you $65,000 and a shot at the car, okay? If you're ready to go, Ian, go ahead and start.
Six, please.
Let's see what's in number six. There's $1,000.
Nine.
Let's see what's in number nine. There's the tick. Find the tack and we give you that jackpot.
Eight for that good old running back trick.
All right. If you get if the tack is behind number eight, you have the jackpot and a shot at a new car. Let's see. Yeah!
Wow!
I need somebody to imitate the dragon.
No!
I don't know what I'm doing behind two, but I'm the green monster. My name ain't Fenway.
Give me your head and I'll steal my flamethrower.
Cover the frog.
Well, the dragon's pissed now because he has not won in a while. Yep, and that's the way we like it around here. Ian, congratulations, $75,790, and price, and you got the prize package included with that. And you want to see what car you're going for?
Sure.
It is a new 2016 Porsche Cayenne worth $57,465, Ian. All right, Ian, where is the car? Is it behind Tick or Tack?
Tick, please.
Who's your favorite model on the Price is Right?
Janice Pennington.
Oh, I love this one. When I was a little boy, Janice, I used to think about you in my sleep. I didn't like the fact that they the cameraman accidentally hit you. I cried all night that night. Let's see it! You got a new car!
Oh,
you're off to a good start, Ian. I think if you win one more game, then you'll be in the top eight.
I hope.
Yep. You have $133,255. We add your previous winnings of $11,000. That gives you a total of
$144,255. Wow.
And guys, that is all the time we have for Tic-Tac-Dough. Did everybody have a good time?
I agree. I won, I beat the dragon.
Yep. Well, guys, the jackpot resets at $25,000. And what can I say? We gave away over, on today's episode, over $250,000. So that's not bad. All right. We'll see y'all next time for Tic-Tac-Dough. Goodbye, y'all.
30 pops.
Man, we giving everything away.
Beat the dragon and all that fun stuff. I love this theme song. Dance.
Join us after this video for Prime Time over the Rodney 1279 stations.
Hey,